Alright, this is for a little Arduino world clock and weather, or a clock weather shower thingy. Anyways, it's a, it goes, connects to a server, and I'll show you the time and weather for 7 different locations. And we'll also check and see if there are any messages for you that have been sent to a server. The way the board works is here, I've got 2 buttons that were going to go to a menu that I never installed. Then I've got the Arduino Ethernet board here. Right here we've got the little RGB LED connected for TX and RX so that it lights up. And we've got some 4050 logic level shifter. I don't know what that does. I guess it does something with the changing the voltage for the Nokia display. And I don't even know if I need that, though. But it came with the display, and they had it hooked up, so might as well do it, right? Anyways, the way it works is, the first thing it does is, when it starts up, is it connects, and connects to an NTP time server. It sends them a little message and then waits for a response to get the GMT or UTC time, then takes that time and converts it for the 7 different locations and saves it in the strings or integers. And then it goes back to the a PHP script I have on a free web host. It tells the PHP script to update itself. When it does that, the PHP script connects to weather.com's RSS feed for each of the locations. And it goes through the RSS feed and converts all the bullshit basically into a little strings that the Arduino board can handle. For some reason, the way I have this the code written, it can handle only very, very small strings. Once they get large, random data starts shooting out, and it doesn't handle it well at all. So all the messages have to be very small, and you really have to clean it a lot, even a whole lot. And anyways, so it gets all that information, and then it saves it into a file on the web server called test.txt. It saves it into a separate file instead of keeping it on the same page and keeping it clean, because the free web host I have likes to add random data anytime you have a PHP or HTML file to the bottom of it, I guess for search engines or something. So, but it doesn't do it with the text files. So it saves all the weather data into test.txt, and then on the same script that updates it, if you were to, well, before we get to that. So after it does that, it downloads from the test.txt the weathers and saves them into strings. Last thing the script does is it goes back to the internet and it checks for a message.txt file, which is where any messages that were sent to the server are going to be saved. And if it sees any, it'll show it to you real quick, like jumping beans, I think is what it's set at right now. Alright. So, anyways. There's the different little locations showing up. Yay. And here's the script on the server. We can type in some random information in here, like hello or hilo gentle, and then send it to the web server. It's going to update it. So like if we go over here to message.txt where it was jumping beans, and you can see the little MG to tell the Arduino board when the message begins. Restart that. It's now hello gentlemen. Okay. So come over here. You can see it updated, but got messed up. But somehow, on the first letter, on the HE, it somehow turned it into a character. Anyways, I'm gonna reset it like that. Let's see how it handles it. thing definitely messes up the memory a lot on the board, however I coded it. So if you know how to work with buffers or something like that, it would probably help out a lot. Versus my strings. I don't know why the strings keep getting so confused. But yeah, you see it show up there. The way the script's set up right now is roughly every 60 seconds it checks for a new message, and then every like 15 minutes it checks for weather. And also every 60 seconds it's checking for it's reconfirming the time. But it has, the strings just kill this thing for some reason. Anyways, before I go, you can see the test file right there, and it shows the weather. See if it changed at all since we updated it. Anything new? No? Same? Yep. Okay. But anyways, that's it. And the code for it, as buggy as it is gonna be right below the video, and you can fuck with it and see how it works. Alright, that's where they go.